gentlemen, please welcome your MC for tonight, Miss Denise Thomas.
Good evening. I am so thrilled that you could join us tonight. We are immensely grateful that you have tuned in to support Cristo Rey Jesuit students. 2020, needless to say, has been quite a year, to say the least, and we here at CRJ are inspired at the commitment and dedication of our students these past several months. And we cannot wait to share the wonderful things that are happening at Cristo Rey, all thanks to support from amazing people like you. As you can see, we are coming to you virtual tonight, and we have a stellar 45-minute lineup, beginning with none other than our own Father Bill Johnson. But before I hand it over to Father Bill, let me say that tonight is all about supporting students at Cristo Rey Jesuit so that they are equipped for lives of purpose in our community. And at any time throughout this program, we want you to simply text CRJ to the number 41444. So again, that means take out your smartphones where you would send a text message. In the message section, type CRJ and send that message to the number 41444, and it will take you from there. Or you can also click the donate button in the top right-hand corner to provide students with an unparalleled education. And if by any chance you happen to enter some extra zeros, let them go through. Just hit the send button. We've got a great show for you tonight. And to get us started, we have Father Bill with a prayer. Father Bill.
Welcome, everyone. Good evening. Let us begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us together this evening, albeit virtually, to support the learning, leadership development, and faith formation of our Cristo Rey students. You've been with us in spirit throughout our first 6 years as we've worked hard with students and families, faculty and staff, our board of directors and generous benefactors to establish our school and root it now in our beautiful new campus at 18th and National. Be with us tonight, Lord, as we celebrate our successes and prepare to meet the challenges of these uncertain times. Bless our hosts and the food and cheer that their guests enjoy in homes throughout the greater Milwaukee area. Keep us all healthy and committed to the mission of Cristo Rey Jesuit High School. Help us to enjoy one another's company and the fun that's about to begin. We pray in the name of Jesus, Cristo Rey, Christ the King. And I invite you all to end our prayer together, as we always do at Cristo Rey with students and staff, by responding, "Pray for us," when I say, "St. Ignatius Loyola," together. St. Ignatius Loyola, pray for us. Amen, and enjoy the evening.
Thank you, Father Bill. Good evening, and welcome, everyone. As the 2020-2021 school year began, we set the theme for our school as embracing new frontiers. Tonight, we embrace the new frontier of the virtual event. We're so thankful that you're joining us tonight. We're also thankful for the many generous sponsors who helped make tonight possible. While tonight is an occasion of celebration, it's important to note the challenges that so many are enduring right now in our community. Families who live on the south side of Milwaukee, where Cristo Rey draws the majority of its students, have and continue to be disproportionately impacted by COVID-19. The burden of this disease falls hardest on those who do not have access to the resources to deal with its, at times, devastating consequences. Faced with this tidal wave of unprecedented questions and concerns, we at Cristo Rey Jesuit were pressed to decide how we would respond to this reality. To find the answer, we went back to our mission. Our Catholic and Jesuit mission calls us to take action out of love for God and our neighbor. And this is how we responded to the needs we saw in our community. We became a food source for families and a remote tech support hub that supported every student with a Chromebook. We offered modest emergency funds to families who experienced job loss, food insecurity, and eviction. We connected families with community health clinics and health resources. We set out to have the safest school environment in Milwaukee. We learned from medical experts, hired school nurses, and made the changes necessary to care for staff and students. We provided counseling to students experiencing emotional trauma and spiritual outreach through prayer and our first ever virtual retreat. Our amazing teachers continued to adapt and tackle huge challenges with the transition to online learning. While we started the year with all students learning online, we acknowledged that education online limits some students' ability to learn and our ability to prepare them for college. While many schools and school districts have continued learning totally online, I'm proud that we have, since mid-September, invited some students back to school in an intentional, safe, and equitable manner to experience the benefits of learning in person in our school building. We are so grateful to many corporate work-study partners for remaining financially supportive of our school, even as our students have remained in virtual training, while those very work partners make the necessary safety changes to their own offices. Our incredible corporate work study team developed and is delivering an innovative new virtual work readiness training so that when the time is right, our students will be ready to be active contributors once again to their workplaces. This response to our times, the perseverance of our students, and our excellent outcomes as an educational institution is what we celebrate tonight. We are all in at Cristo Rey Jesuit, and we need you to stand with us so that we can continue to deliver on our mission. While the landscape around us continues to change, the mission of Cristo Rey remains hopeful, strong, and enduring. Listen in as our students have a brief message for you.
Hi, my name is Josh Rodriguez. I am a 2020 graduate from Cristo Rey, and with your investment in my education, I was able to find the confidence to push forward and reach my dreams.
Hi, I'm Becky Suarez, Director of Admissions at Cristo Rey Jesuit High School. With your help and support, we can have future trailblazer at our school.
Thank you, Northwestern Mutual. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Moody, for helping me with my dreams.
Thank you, Marquette University, for supporting my education.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Music.
Hi, my name is Kate Jorgensen, and I'm a social emotional counselor at Cristo Rey. Thanks to your support, every single student at Cristo Rey has access to one-on-one counseling.
Thank you, Lacey Sadoff Foundation.
Thank you, Hush Blackwell.
Thank you, Manpower.
Thank you, Subjects.
Hey, we thank John and Patty Noel for their sponsorship of tonight's fun.
Thank you, Darren and Terry Jackson Foundation. You're awesome.
Thank you, Dedicated Computing.
Thank you so much for your support, Beth and Will Kubley.
Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Wooden, for supporting my education.
Hi there, I'm Blake, the Math Department Chair at Cristo Rey Jesuit High School, Milwaukee. Thanks to your generous support, all of our students have access to technology and the support they need to become great mathematicians and future leaders of STEM careers in our great city of Milwaukee. Thank you so much.
Thank you for supporting students like me at Cristo Rey. Because of your support, I graduated with 18 college acceptances, and I look forward to becoming an educator.
If you haven't already heard, the Gordon Henke Family Foundation has very generously provided a $50,000 challenge grant. The foundation will match dollar for dollar any gifts received for this event. So don't hesitate. Make your gift right now to double your impact on the lives of our students.
Together, we're helping to prepare a diverse, educated pipeline of tomorrow's leaders. The people who will grow our city, the people who will guide our businesses, lead our government, and navigate future crises. Thank you again for joining us tonight and for your investment in Cristo Rey Jesuit High School. It's already transforming our community. It's made our new campus a beacon of hope for the Clark Square neighborhood. It's given our students incredible opportunities to develop to their God-given potential. It's from here, with your support, that our Trailblazers go out, ready to set their own path and embrace new frontiers. May God bless you and your family.
Thank you so much, Andy. And thank you to our amazing students. And thank you to our donors. Everyone out there who is watching, we could not thank you enough. We also have some contributions coming in already. We want to thank you, the Lorenzi family, for your $5,000 investment toward the education of our students. And thank you to the Getch family for your $1,000 sustaining gift. Thank you, Brian and Carolyn, Chris, and so many more that are pouring hope into the lives of our students. CRJ students have seen great success because each of you out there have invested in them, the future leaders of Milwaukee. We are also immensely grateful for investors and volunteers like Paul Eberle, who is here with us tonight. Good evening, Paul.
Thank you, Denise. We are so blessed to have you leading the program tonight and telling the story of Cristo Rey, Milwaukee. I also want to thank Victoria Rios and her family for telling their story. You will hear from Victoria in a few minutes, and I know you will be inspired. Thank you to all of our sponsors and donors. This night of impact has impact because of you. Your support tonight is going to make a difference for Cristo Rey and the 400-plus kids working through these incredibly challenging times. My wife Paula and I have been involved with Cristo Rey Milwaukee from the beginning, from the original feasibility study, to the original board, to the capital campaign to build the new school building. At every step along that journey, we've seen the Holy Spirit at work in this mission. In 8 short years, an idea turned into a school supported by the local business community. That school grew into a new world-class high school. It's a campus filled with kids who want a better life and a better world, filled with teachers who are on a mission to educate tomorrow's leaders, supported by local businesses and donors who know the importance of a great education for our future workforce. As the CEO of Hush Blackwell, I've had the chance to see Cristo Rey students in the workplace. Our firm supports Cristo Rey in Milwaukee, Kansas City, Dallas, and in other cities across the country. When these kids come to work, they deliver. Cristo Rey is a school that works, and that work experience is critical to their education. Even in these challenging times, I promise that your investment in a Cristo Rey job is an investment that will pay off. This night of impact is a 1-year break from our normal merengue celebration. For those of you that have attended a past merengue, stay with us. We'll be back with live dancing next year. Since we don't want to miss out on all the dancing fun, a few merengue stars have a message for you.
Hi, I'm Eric Getch. I'm the 2019 Milwaukee Stars Merengue Ballroom Champion. Since my outstanding victory, I've been continuing to dance with my partners Megan and Rebecca. I'm getting ready to perform in my first national ballroom competition in Florida in November. So, let me show you what we got.
Yeah, that's real good, Eric, but not good enough. My name is Rich Musin. I'm the 2018 Milwaukee Merengue Dancing with the Stars champion, and I've been dancing for 2 years with my two beautiful partners, and I've been dancing nationally for the last couple of years. So let me show you how it's done, Eric.
Thank you for joining me tonight. I'm Chris Propella, and I have the distinct pleasure of being the very first Milwaukee Stars Merengue Ballroom Champion in 2017. 3 years later, I still dance and I compete nationally and regionally. Come take a look.
I'm Lacey Sadoff, 2018's Judge's Choice and first runner-up. Since then, I've been competing nationally and internationally with my wonderful partner.
We may be fierce competitors on the dance floor, but when it comes to the Cristo Rey students, we couldn't be more in sync.
If it wasn't for CRJ, we wouldn't have had this wonderful opportunity to dance. And opportunity is what it's all about with the students.
The unparalleled education that students receive at Cristo Rey Jesuit creates endless opportunities for the future. 100% of Cristo Rey Jesuit students graduates with a college acceptance in hand.
And because of Cristo Rey's work experience program, these students are learning to be the leaders for tomorrow. I hope you'll join all of us in supporting this very worthy program. Thank you.
Wow! Thank you so much, Paul, for sharing. You have got to love the dancers' competitive spirit, especially since it is all to support, again, our amazing students. As they've mentioned, now more than ever, the students and families of Cristo Rey Jesuit need your support. CRJ students have proven time and time again that they are committed to their education. They are growing in faith, prepared to lead, and called to serve. By texting CRJ to the number 41444 now. Again, texting CRJ to the number 41444 now, you can ensure that Cristo Rey students continue to have the rigorous education, faith formation opportunities, and a work-study experience that will propel them to be leaders here in Milwaukee. And at any time throughout the program, simply text CRJ to 41444, or you can click the donate button that is also located in the top right-hand corner. I am pleased to introduce to you one such leader, Victoria Rios. Welcome, Victoria.
Hi, Denise. Thank you for having me.
Oh, it is my pleasure. Thank you for being here. So Victoria is a member of the inaugural class graduating in 2019 and a first generation college student in her family. Now, can you believe it has been a year and a half already since you graduated?
Yeah, it's crazy. The year went by so fast. I'm already a sophomore.
Already, extremely. Cristo Rey was a brand new school and you came in as a member of their very first class. In fact, we featured you in a video all those years ago. Take a look at this.
I wanted to come to Cristo Rey
And my family did too. I heard it was different. They want us to work. In a hospital, a bank, professional environments.
So Victoria, tell us about your CRJ experience. How did a CRJ education prepare you for the future, guide you, and challenge you?
Yes, it taught me a lot about leadership and a lot about communication. And I was a very shy student freshman year to start off. And although I still, you know, get anxious at times, I feel like more confident in myself. And I feel like a proper like student and a worker. It was definitely, you know, challenging at some points where, you know, I was put into a new environment, such as like the corporate work study world, where I was, you know, a 14-year-old student in a financial firm. So that was obviously something I was new to and something I was very shy at first. However, I did learn to grow in my communication skills. I learned a lot of work skills that I now implement into my life today. And along with Cristo Rey, I was able to grow as a student and as a leader through developing all these clubs and sports, which is something that I was always like really involved in throughout high school. I was like, you know, part of the first choir, basketball team, track, cross country. And it was just really great that I was able to help develop all of those programs. We were able to like grow the culture in each one of those like aspects. And it's obviously something like, it's a big honor to be able to do that.
Well, it is an honor to sit next to you, Victoria. You are incredible. I can see why Cristo Rey is such an incredible institution of learning, producing amazing leaders like you. I'm just honored to be sitting next to you and listening to your amazing journey. Now, as we had talked about, you were the first graduating class and a first generation college student. And congratulations again, by the way. I want to take a look at this clip, and then can you give us an update on how your accomplishments have affected you as well as your family? Let's take a look.
So my mom and my dad, they want me to do really well in school. They want me to go to college, have a good job in the future, because I'm going to be the first generation in my family to be going to college. So they really want that for me.
Yeah, I want the best. Yeah, I really, 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 really like the best for my daughter.
So, as I said, it did. My high school experience definitely shaped me into the student and the worker that I am today. Obviously, being the first, you know, graduating class of Cristo Rey alone is something really big to accomplish. But the fact that I'm going to college now and as a first-generation college student, I'm making my family members proud. I'm setting an example for my younger siblings and setting an example for my cousins and, you know, younger Cristo Rey students, the future, you know, Cristo Rey alumni. And it's something, obviously, I'm really proud of myself for that. Really proud of everything that I did throughout high school, again, like through teamwork and leadership opportunities that I've taken that built me into the person that I am today. And yeah, it's something that, like, I feel like, again, like really proud of myself in. My parents are really proud of me, grandparents, everyone. And it's, I wouldn't have seen myself here today if I wouldn't have gone to Cristo Rey. And that's something I could definitely advocate for through you know, like all of Cristo Rey's values and everything that they try to teach the students into becoming a holistic person, the cura personalis that I always thought was really important. And I could see how that paid off in the end as I'm, you know, I'm at Marquette University, you know, studying corporate communications, which is something that I've grown a lot of interest in throughout like different interviews, throughout talking to different people. I've really enjoyed just communicating with others throughout like my Cristo Rey experience, throughout my work experience. And so, you know, it ultimately brought me to where I am today, you know, sitting here with you right now. And it's something that I'm really proud of myself for, and I know that I'm making my family proud as well.
Well, I'm just beginning to know you, Victoria, and I'm already proud. One of the things I also want to ask you, at Cristo Rey Jesuit, it is a requirement that all seniors graduate with one or more acceptances to a college. And I know this was an opportunity that your parents did not have and were so happy that CRJ ensured that you had that experiences. Now let's take a look, because here's what they said all those years ago.
This is a college prep school. They're trying to prepare us for college.
Our expectation is that 100% of our students will attend college.
Neither of my parents have been to college.
We cannot afford it, and I start working at a young age, and always thinking to take some preparation in the future. But when you get married, you have your kids, and then it's every time getting harder and harder, and now we're focused on my daughter.
We graduate young people who are prepared for the world. And what that means is that they're well-rounded, that they're spiritually grounded and formed. When they graduate Cristo Rey, they are a person who knows the importance of God in their lives and can see where God is active. Our students and families support us, believe in us, trust us, and know that ultimately we're shepherding their children in the right direction.
They put my treasure on their hands.
So Victoria, after watching that clip, wanted to ask you, how were your first months at Marquette University? Did you feel prepared? And how were you ready and how were you not?
Mm-hmm. Yes, so my first few months at Marquette University were really great, although a little stressful and obviously like difficult. I feel like Cristo Rey definitely prepared me a lot in like those college level classes, picking up some study habits here and there. However, I never felt like fully prepared for college, because you never know what to expect from certain professors or the way your schedule is going to be set out, especially me too, that I was also working part-time. So it was very interesting to see how I scheduled, you know, my classes and made time for work and made time for myself. And that was something, obviously, I had to learn once going into college. However, again, just the way that I was in high school, I try to like carry that into college, you know, always making sure I stay as focused as possible, keeping up that work ethic, and just doing the best that I can, and also seeking out those resources and always asking questions, which is something I was always taught at Cristo Rey, which again, I still carry that into my life today, both in school and in my workplace, so that I can just keep learning more and more.
It is obvious. It is obvious that you are continuously improving. And I know for the folks in the audience that are witnessing Victoria, we continue to just be so impressed by your accomplishments and sharing so many great things that you are experiencing at Marquette University. And as you well know, Cristo Rey has a very unique work-study program. So let's also take a few moments to watch this clip.
Cristo Rey Jesuit is the only school where every single student works one day a week to help pay for the cost of their education, but also gain this really valuable work experience that helps animate their academic life.
They are getting this incredible experience in the business environment and a professional environment. They are gaining coaches and mentors and professional experiences way beyond their years.
You're really growing the next generation of workers, right? So, I mean, you know, we talk so much about recruiting here and, you know, wanting to get great candidates in the door. And I think the best way to do that is starting early.
This side or the other side?
We're learning how to talk to adults. We're learning how to be professional. All of those things that you learn once you've already graduated college, and we're having a glimpse of that.
Hello, Baird Advisors. This is Victoria speaking.
So, Victoria, after watching that clip regarding work study, I wanted to ask you, how did your time with the work study program affect your college career path?
I learned a lot from working at Baird, and it's been honestly one of the biggest blessings that I've like ever had, and I've just been so grateful for this opportunity. The fact that I was placed there as a 14, 15-year-old, and I'm still there at 19 years old. And I feel like absolutely everyone that I've talked to in that office has been some sort of a mentor for me. whether it was my managers or my coworkers. And it's just been really wonderful to be able to be in a team that genuinely cared about me as a person, as a student, and as a worker.
Words that we can all live by. We are powering through it, and I can definitely tell that you are someone who is continuing to push through. Incredible. I just love having this conversation with Victoria. I seriously could be here for the rest of the night until midnight. So as we're closing up, a few more questions. This is incredible. You've already spent 5 years at Baird. 5 years, and you're 19 years old. That is amazing. And another thing that we're going to have is a short clip hearing from our friends at Baird.
The return on investment from what is really a relatively small financial commitment in terms of the impact on that child's life, as well as their family's life, and ultimately our community and our firm, is priceless.
Wow, that was an incredible video. So Victoria, I know that the folks out there, along with myself, are just continuing to just feel amazed about so much that you've accomplished in a short time frame. How does it feel to be so accomplished at such a young age?
It feels very fulfilling and very wonderful overall. It definitely gives me a lot of purpose in what I'm doing and like who I'm becoming. And it keeps me motivated overall to keep trying at school, keep, you know, like asking questions, keep trying to become a better version of myself. Because, you know, with everything going on during the pandemic, especially, and just like overall, like with school and work and everything gets stressful, everything gets tiring, you know, it's normal for everyone. But, you know, just the fact that I've accomplished so much, and just like remembering like, oh, I was, you know, I'm still first generation. I was first graduating class. I'm, you know, working 5 years at Baird now. Just like seeing all these different accomplishments that I've done, all these like milestones, I guess, it keeps me motivated and it keeps me like proud of myself, and it makes me want to do more. Like, I'm not gonna like stop here. I'm just gonna keep trying to do more. And yeah, it's just that those accomplishments are making me into who I am today.
I love it. I love it. So inspiring. So inspiring. If I could, I would give you a high five. So I'm just going to just send you a virtual high five, Victoria. Absolutely incredible. Amazing. This is the product, the future leaders of Milwaukee. This is what Cristo Rey Jesuit is supporting and producing in this city. Absolutely continue to be amazed. Thank you so much for being here tonight, Victoria.
No, thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. I know I say this on behalf of everyone that is watching. We are so extremely proud of all your accomplishments. Keep up the great work. And thank you for your leadership. You truly define what it means to be a trailblazer. And you are an inspiration to the future Cristo Rey graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, Victoria Rios. Do not forget, based on what you've just experienced, to text CRJ to the number 41444 to make a donation so that we can continue to inspire and experience students such as our incredible Victoria. From graduates to current students, in-person classes to virtual learning, Cristo Rey Milwaukee is a strong community. Let's hear from our on-site news anchor, Principal Luke Harrison. Luke?
All right, we are here with Luke Harrison, principal at Cristo Rey Jesuit High School and lead anchor of the internet phenomenon, CRJ Good News.
And we're also here with Andrew Boddy Spargo, who is, director, screenwriter, cinematographer, editor, sound production director, and key grip. Thanks for being with us, Mr. Boddy Spargo. Good to have you here.
Happy to be here. So our videos became wildly popular in the CRJ community and beyond, thanks to the contributions of staff and students and the fun and the motivational tone of the videos. And also just the meaningful content that we put in there. hundreds of people watched your videos within hours of the upload. And that's a big success. What do you attribute that success to?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I think a big part of it is that they were all required to watch it. We've got an audience of hundreds of students. You make them watch it, there's your audience. So in fact, that's one of my takeaways, is if you can get yourself a good audience that can't avoid watching it, go for it. Well, what do you attribute the success to, Mr. Buddy Spargo?
Well, it might have had something to do with the dozens of hours that I put in editing and cutting, and especially removing all the mistakes you would make during the takes and things like that, so that it looked smooth and professional.
I suppose there's that too. Well, Mr. Bryce Spargo, where did you get the idea in the first place to make it into kind of a newsroom-style show? Because that was really your idea.
Well, we just kind of ripped off John Krasinski. He had recently done that Some Good News segment that went viral on YouTube. And as long as we're giving, you know, pieces of advice, I'd say to filmmakers, try to steal as many ideas as you can, just like rip off of other people. Actually, maybe we should just stop giving advice.
Yeah, we should probably avoid that advice. But what we did realize after the Krasinski inspiration for the title was that as a Catholic Jesuit school, we are all about the good news of the gospel. So the title works in that way for our school, too. This school is all about spreading that good news.
Yeah, that's right. And so let's take a look back at some of the highlights from those videos where we used a combination of insights into teachers' lives and ingenuity and editing just to surprise people and help them have some fun. So let's take a look at a couple of those right now.
Wait, why isn't there anybody? Oh, coronavirus. We had to close. That's right. Well, might as well see if anyone shows up.
Seeing all the great work that students and staff have done so far since we've gone online makes me feel like I could do anything, like jump on top of that trash can. Keep up the great work, Cristo Rey. Don't try that at home. And actually, some of those inspired students to take their own version of what we were doing and try their own. So here are a couple of those.
All the great work you guys have been doing makes me think I can knock down that bottle with this frisbee.
Our faculty was also excited, those who are parents, to share insights into the joys of remote teaching while parenting, as you may remember. They wanted to make sure they were anxious to convey to the community a sense of control and stability in their homes at a time when so much seemed to be in upheaval.
Yeah, not sure if that is always what came through, though.
This is Aaron Hess reporting live from West Allis, Wisconsin, with the weekly parenting update. Actually, parenting has been pretty decent, pretty easy since COVID has begun. Really, the only things that you got to keep in mind as a parent, discipline, maintaining just a second.
Airbus, what are you doing?
Sorry, Daddy. Okay, Daddy.
Dude, Atticus, what are you doing?
I'm playing soccer.
That's a baseball. Dude, go outside. Hooray!
We sure did. This is a great time over here.
Everybody.
Everything is so great. We just start figuring it out every day. This is fun. This is fun.
Hi, everyone. This is Mr. Stith coming to you from my home office.
Dad,
I'm so proud to tell you.
Toilet paper again in here.
cut, cut.
Even though there was so much instability going on, one thing that really was stable is the exceptional perseverance and the achievements that we saw from our graduating class that year.
Absolutely, and in addition to that, we had a couple student writers who were recognized for a regional August Wilson writing competition.
Hi, I'm Taina.
And I'm Elijah.
And we are both seniors at Cristo Rey Jesuit High School.
And because of your support, we are wearing big white smiles that you can't see because of these big white masks.
CRJ has helped us foster educational and artistic talents by letting us participate in classes of the arts and by letting us participate in the August Wilson Monologue Competition hosted by Milwaukee Repertory Theater. And Elijah actually won runner-up prize.
Runner-up. I mean, she won first place. Which is great. I'm not devastated that I didn't win first place because, you know, I won runner-up. That's like second best. And, you know, I'm good with that.
There are many talented students here at CRJ.
Including Reginald Johnson.
Whose poetry was just published in a book.
Which is the equivalent of winning first place for poetry.
And here's Reggie.
Life hits you like a bad breakup. Don't know what to make of these lies. Never had time to let go of the past. Now I'm thinking about my mom, full of hatred in her eyes. Won't show her emotion because of her pride. And I cry to let my ego rest. Nothing but lies in my family tree. No truth involved. How am I supposed to save the world if I can't save y'all? Why the past and future problems? Making up false tales so you could tell white lies about your loved ones. Am I chopped liver in the family of wolves and sheep's clothing? Ain't no telling what the ending will be. Please tell me if I fail myself. Pushing off these lies so I can really trust myself. It took time to really find myself now. I'm helping my family find their own while breaking through this iron wall of depression and trailblazing through these thoughts of negativity and self-doubt. The goal is to find their confidence and self-worth. The mindset of a broken child, find a crack in his life and grow above it like a rose that grew through the concrete.
You know, you're right that it took a ton of work. It must have been pretty grueling for you producing this every weekend.
Yeah, it definitely took a lot of time. Of course, I did have to, you know, purchase some tech tools, not toys, obviously, some tools to help with the production that, you know, I just needed to have those. So that was another little benefit. But really, it just brought me a lot of joy to have that be something that so many students and staff told me that they brought them joy at the beginning of their week.
Yeah, it sure did. You know, life as a principal can get tremendously busy too sometimes. I mean, so much so that I, you may remember, had to bring in substitute anchors a couple times to take over.
Oh, yeah.
I'm your anchor this week, Turd Ferguson. Really? Really? I'm your anchor this week, Ron Burgundy Millerman.
Good morning, Cristo Rey Jesuit High School. This is this week's episode of CRJ Good News, and I'm your anchor, Miss McConnell. Mr. Harrison let me know that he was going to be busy this weekend, so I volunteered to help him. So me and my co-anchor Pepper are here to deliver your CRJ Good News.
Miss McConnell, it's Maeve and Naylan, the principal's daughters. We know our dad told you he was very busy and he had a lot of work to do this week, so he needed you to do the announcements, but we wanted to show you what he was really up to.
Here comes the cross, he's got on out of. He goes up, hit it, go! Oh, hey, Maeve and Anthony, what are you guys up to?
We're recording you so we can send this video to Ms. McConnell about what you've been really doing.
Wait, what are you talking about? That's disrespectful, what do you mean?
It's disrespectful to lie to Ms. McConnell.
That's an infraction.
What's an infraction?
For crying out loud.
Dad, you need a haircut.
That's another infraction. Both of you just give me the phone. Get out of here. Both of you just get out of here.
Andrew, I told you to leave that segment out. No respect.
Well, we just had a lot of fun. And actually, a lot of staff contributed really fun segments throughout.
Whoa. Thank you, Mr. Harrison. It is me, Miss Young, your chief dance move correspondent, here to share with you guys a new dance move I just created. Feel free to try this one at home. I like to call it the dry erase board.
and the missed spot. Okay.
Whoa. Excuse me, Mr. Harrison? I think we got a problem here. There must be some confusion. I'm pretty sure I am, and always will be, the chief dance correspondent. Check this out.
Hot. Ooh, jumping out the grease. It's a whole lot of degrees. About to come, about to please.
So after all that success in the spring with sharing the good things that are happening in our community, what are the things that we've been talking about and we are going to be talking about this fall?
Yeah, we've been talking a lot about this just gorgeous building that we're in. It's almost hard to believe is ours to put to use. It's just been a phenomenal celebration, frankly. The brand new athletic facilities, these gorgeous classrooms with huge windows, a just sacred chapel for prayer and formation, and a commons that pulls us all together as a community as well. It's been a real celebration of that space.
Yeah, and in the classrooms, we have seen an amazing dedication and innovation from our teachers. They have, whether they've been working from home in the beginning of the year to transitioning into the building, to now teaching a combination of remote and in-person students in a way that is safe, educational, and really engaging for those students is incredible to see.
Yeah, and watching our students and families just embrace that and the joy in their faces when they come in, even if their faces are covered with masks like ours are, it's just really an inspiration as well. And it's just such a salient reminder of the gift that it is to walk with our students and the focus that we have on this mission of empowerment, of empowering students to be the next generation of Jesuit leaders, men and women, for and with others, through an academic program that's robust and rigorous, through a corporate work study program that's innovative and cutting edge, through arts education, through ministry and spiritual and religious formation. It's just a gift to be here and be a part of this mission.
Amen.
Thank you again to our amazing CRJ staff and students for sharing your good news with us tonight. So much is happening in the Crystal Ray community, and I am so energized by the passion and commitment of our incredible students.
And I couldn't agree more. And with your donation tonight, students will have all the resources needed to excel in college and beyond. Students will bravely embrace the new frontiers with you by their side. Thank you for tuning in to celebrate with us. Even though our time tonight is finished, your support is critical to sustain Cristo Rey Jesuits' momentum in Milwaukee. Please consider a donation to ensure that our students today become leaders of tomorrow. Don't forget to text to CRJ to 41444 to make a donation or go online anytime to give. Special thanks to Paul and Paula Eberle, our co-chairs for tonight's event. Our MC, Denise Thomas, Jessica Pelinar, Shannon Watry, and our entire advancement team. Thank you on behalf of our students, families, and staff at Cristo Rey Jesuit. You are a blessing to us. Take care and have a great night.